D-Day was the day, I tell you. This was the day where every student in Birmingham knew that it was going to happen.
But you've got to remember that all of the planning was a secret.
Good. Googly woogly. Good morning, children.
Up in the morning and out to school. The teacher is teaching the golden rule.
I remember that morning I woke up with my mind on freedom.
Oh, I took special pain with putting a little starch in my blouse.
Got my toothbrush and I got the toothpaste, the soap.
Because I had a feeling that I wouldn't be coming home.
Ring, ring goes the bell.
This doctor pushed D-Day early in the morning, but they wouldn't even use D-Day. They use all that jive talk.
Don't forget, kids.
There's gonna be a party in the park. Don't forget your toothbrushes, because luncheon will be served.
Back in the classroom, open your book.
Now, everybody who's listening knows what the deal is.
D-Day was the day. My mother said, okay, Gwen, don't go to that march. Hey, I mean, don't go. You go to school. I told my mother, I said, I hear you. We were raised not to lie. Mm-mm. So I didn't tell her a lie and say I wasn't going. I said, I hear you.
We would have people picked out. Your job is to turn this fire alarm, turn that fire alarm, get the football team, basketball team, get the cheerleaders, get the band.
It was right at 11 o'clock when they arrived. They came up to the fence with a sign that just said, it's time.
When we said, let's go for the window.
And I told the husband, come on, let's go. And I looked around and, you know, all I could see was my own fanny almost, you know. I hollered back up at those kids, but you said you were gonna go. You know, you promised. And that's when kids started coming.
They were coming out of windows, coming out of doors.
It's so beautiful. You wouldn't believe it.
Mrs. Gorey turned her back as we got up.
And we took it from there.
I wanted to walk out with them, but it was my job.
There was nothing you could do once the students started moving. The principal, the teachers, and everybody had to step aside.
My boyfriend tried to stop me from going, and I walked around the building, and I came right back. I didn't want to get.
You have about 2 children left in the class, maybe. Everybody's gone.
I'm sure that morning, Bevel was nervous about who was going to show up.
At first, there were a few, then there were hundreds, then there were thousands.
We heard that kids were coming in from all over the city. And when we heard that they were coming in from out of town, we got more excited.
And I had a cool car, you know. They said, okay, we need you to go out to Fairfield. There's some students outside the classroom that won't go back in. Lo and behold, when I got out to Fairfield, the whole campus was outside of the building. And they all said, we going to Birmingham.
20 kids climbed on the car, and 800 followed behind it.
I love the way you walk. I love the way you walk.
The more we walked, the more we gathered. And every once in a while, you look back and you saw it was more kids coming from somewhere, from another direction. You said, where are all these kids coming from?
You had never seen that many people in your life. It's like a football game.
Kids walk as far as 18 miles to get to Birmingham in order to be arrested.
And the purpose was to go to jail.
The gathering place was 16th Street Baptist Church.
Oh, we poured into 16th Street like a waterfall.
They were coming in all doors, from all directions, from the basement, from the back.
It was just like one big pep rally. Here's Park, are you in the house? Or Western, are you in the house?
And who's out here from Western Heights?
Children were ready.
They were ready to hit the streets.